Hi, it's Vicky here with a birthday card. Today I will be using this adorable bunny, and that's a stamp by Whimsy Stamps. I have already clinked it on my acrylic block, but I am going to show you how they come. They actually come in a big block like this one, and you have to peel off the bag, and then they nicely stick on your acrylic block. And I always like to cut out all the excess of that rubber stamp, because that way it stamps even better. So I am using my Tim Hall scissors, and I'm making nice and straight cuts. So I'm going to show you how this ends up. And once that's done, I am ready to stamp. I'm going to leave that aside, as I will be using that doggy in a future video. And today I will be using this bunny on the present. So I'm going to stamp it on white cardstock by using black ink. And I'm going to use my Prismacolors today to color everything. There is also a giveaway running on my blog right now, so if you want a chance to win this adorable bunny by Whimsy Stamps, make sure to visit my blog and enter your name. I have selected those Prismacolor pencils to get a nice and springy look. I'm also going to use Gamsol as well as those paper tools to blend everything. You really don't need Gamsol, I just love that smooth effect that it gives. Now I'm also going to use my Prismacolor sharpener, and when I sharpen my pencils, I make sure that I don't go hard with the pencil. I just make one or half of a turn with my pencil. And Prismacolors actually recommend to turn the sharpener instead of the pencil. But anyway, I will go ahead and start applying my color. I have already applied my pink, and now I'm blending everything with my Gamsol. Now, I really love this technique, and I find that coloring with Prismacolors is very easy, easier than Copics, just because you don't have to go quickly, and once you apply color, it doesn't dry on you, so you don't have to quickly move on and blend all the colors. So you will see that I am going to apply all the colors on the bunny, and then I am going to use my Gamsol to blend everything out. On screen you can see the exact color name of the Prismacolor that I am using each time. I am going to put on some music while I am coloring, and I'll catch you up again once everything is finished. Now that I am happy with how it is colored, I am going to use my scissors and cut it out. It's not that difficult as it looks. I am taking my time and go around the edges, and I am always going at the end with my black marker and go around the edges. This is going to cover up any mistake that I made while cutting out my bunny, and it's going to make it look perfect. For my main panel, I have cut out two pieces, one with scalloped edge and this one, which is going to be the sky for my scene. So I am going to use my blending tool and I am going to color this white panel using tumbled glass. I am starting out from one edge, and as I go towards the other edge, I'm not applying too much pressure. So I will end up with a piece of cardstock that has more blue on one side and fades out as you look towards the other side. Now for the grass, I am going to use again my blending tool and I am going to apply shabby shatters, but this time I wanted to keep those scalloped edges free of ink, just because this is going to give a nice contrast between the green and the blue. And it's going to make my card look even cuter. To cover up my scalloped edge, as you can see, I've been super frugal. I'm just using pieces from this post-it notepad. And now I can use my mini blending tool to apply my ink. Again, I'm using shabby shatters. And I am being really careful not to move that post-it tape. For my sentiment, I am going to use a die cut that says Happy Birthday, and it comes from this Whimsy stamp die set that has really beautiful sentiments for birthdays, and it's called Birthday Sentimentables Die. So now that my sentiment is ready, all that's left to do is to assemble my card. To do so, I am going to use some foam squares at the back of my grass. This is going to add a little bit of dimension, which I really love on my cards. I believe that it makes them look more interesting and more finished, more professional. And I am also going to stick the bunny. Again, I have used foam tape at the back, and I have also doubled up the foam tape where it was needed, just to make sure that I get everything nicely leveled. To stick down my sentiment, I am going to use a little bit of gel medium, which I am going to apply just with my finger at the back. I think that this is really easy to do. And the great thing about using a gel medium as a glue is not only that it sticks nicely, but it doesn't leave any gloss when it dries. So even if my glue touches any area apart from the back of the sentiment, it's not going to show. So my main panel is ready. I'm going to stick that on top of a standard card. So this is a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And I am going to do some finishing touches now. I am just going to add a little bit of clear Wink of Stella glitter pen on the ribbon. I also added some glitter on the sentiment as well as on the bunny ears and the nose. And I am going to finish it off by adding some glossy accents on the ribbon. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the card. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more birthday cards that I made a while back. Thank you all for watching!